Hi friends, this is me Harshita here and topic for today is brain tumors. It is a very important topic both in terms of pathology and neuro. That is, it's important for even the NEMANS exam. So let's start from the basics. Basically the cells are of two types, neural and neuroglial cells. In the neuroglial cells, we can further divide it as the one which are derived from the neuroectrodermal and the one which are derived from mesodermal. Okay, so from the neuroectodermal comes the glial cells, from the mesodermal comes the microglial cells. In the glial cells, there are three types, that is astrocytes, oligodendrocytes and ependymoma cells. So coming to the first one, astrocytes, the function of astrocytes is, it is BBB, that is blood-brain barrier banata hai, that is astrocytes. Then oligodendrocytes are the one which will form the myelin. So myelin stains, special stain used for myelin is LFB, Luxel Fast Blue. Remember, myelin is helps in transmission of the impulses fastly, so is the fast. So fastly, so stain is also Luxel Fast Blue. So fast and fast, remember that way. And E is ventricle lining. These are the cells which lines the ventricles. So this is all about the glial cells. And coming to microglial cells, these are the modified macrophages. So this is about the types of the cells. Coming to the brain tumors grading, the brain tumors grading are of termed as St. Annie Mayo grading. So according to that, it is amine. So amine matlab A is ataphia, M is mitosis, E is endothelial proliferation, N is necrosis. So it is like ataphia, you should remember this, ataphia, mitosis, endothelial proliferation and necrosis. So the grading is like this. If it is grade 1, all the 4 of them are absent. If it is grade 2, only first one is present. Grade 3 is the next 2 of the amine is positive. 4 is either 3 of them positive or all 4 positive. So you just remember, if someone asks you what is the thing in grade 3, you should start writing this this word AMEN. If they say 3, you should write only 2 letters. If they ask grade 2, you should write only the first one. If they ask the grade 4, you should write the 3, the first 3. And even the everything is positive, like AMEN, everything if positive, then it is known as then also it is known as grade 4 only. So now we learned the basic cells and the St. Annie Mayo grading. We learned that. And in that there were 4 grades. Now let us discuss about the individual brain tumors. So coming to the first one, it is astrocytoma. Astrocytoma is divided into 4 main types. First one being juvenile pilocytic astrocytoma. Even SEGA comes in grade 1. And the next one is pleomorphic xanthoastrocytoma. Remember PXA. Okay. And the third one is anaplastic astrocytoma, grade 3. Grade 4 is glioblastoma multiforme. Okay. So the grade 1 is juvenile pilocytic astrocytoma and SIGA. Grade 2 is the thing with X. That is pleomorphic xanthoastrocytoma. Grade 3 is anaplastic astrocytoma. Grade 4 is GBM. So we learned the 4 grades. Coming to the important aspects of the individual tumors, juvenile pilocytic astrocytoma is a tumor which is most common in the age group of children. And the site of the tumor is cerebellum. And the prognosis is very good. And this is the tumor where there is a characteristic thing called as characteristic features of the pilocytic astrocytoma includes rosenthal fibers positive, mural nodules positive. This is all about juvenile pilocytic astrocytoma. Coming to GBM, GBM is glioblastoma multiforme. It occurs in frontal lobe. Just remember, juvenile pilocytic is in cerebellum, whereas GBM most common site is frontal lobe. And this is the malignant. As the grade increases, the malignancy also increases. So GBM is the malignant form, most malignant form of the astrocytoma group. So it is the, so when you have to treat it, you have to ट्रीट लाइक इन ऑल एस्पेक्ट, यू जस्ट रिमेंबर दैट वे. लाइक सर्जरी भी करना है और रेडियोथेरेपी कीमोथेरेपी सब कुछ करना है. सो द कीमो एजेंट ऑफ चॉइस इज टेमसोलोमाइड, ओके टेमसोलोमाइड. एंड द जीबीएम इज अ ट्यूमर विच क्रॉसेज द मिड लाइन, सो इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज बटरफ्लाई ट्यूमर. सो एंड यू शुड ऑल्सो रिमेंबर द इम्पॉर्टेंट हिस्टोलॉजिकल फीचर्स ऑफ जीबीएम, दैट इज द थ्री मेन कैरेक्टर्स, दैट इज when you after seeing this video you go through the textbook which you are following and see the microscopic picture of astrocytoma, and you should definitely try to remember the points which I have said in this, that is serpentine necrosis, pseudopalisading of tumor cells and glomeruloid bodies. Serpentine necrosis ka matlab is the necrosis appears in the histology as a pinkish mass, pinkish deposition like that, right, in HND. So there will be a serpentine kind of thing in which there will be necrosis and the tumor cells palisade all around. This would be a histopath, so everything would be pink, this is the appearance of the GBM. So there will be a necrosis and the tumor cells form the palisading around. And there is endothelial proliferation giving rise to what is known as glomeruloid bodies. So we learnt about GBM, and in GBM 90% of the cases it is IDH wild type and 10% is IDH mutant type. Wild type is the most common and it occurs de novo and in older age group, whereas the mutant form is rare to occur and occurs in the young, and mutant is something which is secondary, okay. Wild type occurs de novo, but this mutant is secondary to the low grade brain tumors. So we learnt about GBM. Now let's move to the next tumor, that is oligodendroglioma. The most common mutation is IDH. You should also remember that oligodendroglioma is a brain tumor in which there is calcium deposition can also be present. This is a very important feature because there are only three brain tumors which has the there are only three main brain tumors that has calcium deposits that can occur with calcium deposition. So oligodendroglioma mein you will get calcium deposition, and there can also be hemorrhage, and this is also a tumor that arises most commonly in the frontal lobe. So coming to the characteristic appearance, you have to remember the given points very thoroughly. That is, fried egg appearance will be positive in oligodendroglioma. You just remember O is like an egg, so egg appearance, fried egg appearance. In fact, the fried egg appearance is due to the perinuclear hollow. This perinuclear hollow gives the fried egg appearance. And the next thing is, I said it has calcification. The type of calcification it has is chicken wire calcification. So you remembered O is like egg. So it is a fried egg appearance, also known as perinuclear hollow. And when there is egg, there will be chicken. Remember that way. So it is chicken wire calcification. Okay. Then the capillaries are also present. So anastomosing capillaries will be present. And you will find perinuclear satellitosis. These words are very characteristic. The question can be of any type, and always the examiner will somewhere give a clue by giving either the histopath finding or the location finding, or the question might just say it is a tumor with calcification. So this will help you to rule out the options and get the right answer. So this is about oligodendroglioma. Now let's move to the next tumor. That is ependymoma. Ependymoma arises from ependymal cells. So ependymoma can be from the ventricle lining or the spinal cord. When the epithelium lining goes down into the spinal cord, right? So this can arise from both sides, that is from spinal cord or the fourth ventricle. But in adults, the most common site is spinal cord. But in the first to two decades, it is the fourth ventricle. Okay. So in the ependymoma, you have a special feature called rosettes. So the type of rosette which is present in ependymoma is perivascular pseudorosette. So perivascular pseudorosette. Remember, the when there is a word called pseudo, pseudo rosette is something that the cells are in a rosette form, but the inside of the rosette will have some deposition. Then it is called pseudo rosette. And in ependymoma, it is perivascular pseudo rosette because the center is with the vascular blood vessel. So the rosette has something in the center. So it is pseudo rosette. And the center part, the thing which is present is the vascular. So the term used for ependymoma is perivascular pseudo rosette. So this is ependymoma. And coming to the treatment, it is ependymoma is you have to do the surgery and craniospinal radiation, because it has can occur in as I said, it is a lining epithelium which continues down. So the treatment is craniospinal RT plus surgery, and this is about ependymoma. Coming to the next one, that is medulloblastoma. Medulloblastoma is the most common brain tumor in the children. And coming to the site, it is again in the cerebellum. Till now, we learned many tumors, and in that astrocytoma, we had juvenile pilocytic astrocytoma. The site was again cerebellum only. And we learned GBM, the site was frontal lobe. And we learned oligodendroglioma, most common site again is frontal lobe. And now we read about ependymoma. The site is spinal cord and fourth ventricle. That is, in adult it is spinal cord, and in earlier decade it is fourth ventricle. Now medulloblastoma, the site is cerebellum. Hope this is clear till now. Coming to the next point, it is CSF with a drop mets. This drop metastasis is a unique feature again in the medulloblastoma. And as I said, in ependymoma you get the perivascular pseudorosette. In medulloblastoma you'll get HW pseudorosette. You remember, like see this M ko ulta karo, so you'll get this W. Like, so remember that way. Like medulloblastoma, right pseudorosette hoga. Like homerite pseudorosette is present in medulloblastoma. There is one more rosette, that is flexointestinal rosette, that is present in retinoblastoma. So till now we learned three types of rosettes. One is perivascular pseudo rosette in ependymoma, and homerite rosette in medulloblastoma, and flexointestinal rosette in retinoblastoma. Okay. So the next thing is the molecular classification of the medulloblastoma can be done as following: WNT type, SHH type, non-WNT, non-HH with N-mic amplification. And the next one is non-WNT, non-HH without N-mic amplification. Okay. So the best prognosis is the one with a WNT thing. And the worst prognosis is the third one. Okay. If someone asks where is the desmoplasia present, it is the second type, SHH type. So basically you should remember, one is WNT, the next one is SHH, and third and fourth is the similar kind, that is non-WNT, non-SHH. But third one is with N-mic amplification, fourth one is without N-mic amplification. And the tumor with the best prognosis is the WNT type, and the tumor with the worst prognosis is the third one. And the tumor which has desmoplasia is the SHH type. And you should remember, SHH is found in basal cell carcinoma also. And this N-mic which we talked about is present in neuroblastoma also. Okay. And this is all about the medulloblastoma important points. Coming to the next tumor, that is meningioma.